Ooh. Welcome to my little universe. First time booting up this game. From what I have learned, it was originally a mobile game. So take that as you will, but we are going to be giving it a little bit of a look-see here and seeing if this PC port is worth playing. So. Hopefully that should be good. Good audio levels. All good. I tend to do a split like this. Controls. Tab is for switch tool. Oops, sorry. Tool and stuff. I'm already swearing. I'm sorry. Chromatic aberration, SSAO, color grade, vignette. Lens distortion. All right. Nothing about motion blur. I'm hoping there isn't any. Apparently we start up a new game. Oh, it's multiplayer potentially. Let's go. All right. We will do automatic. All right. What axe? Oh, there's an axe. All right. So we got a little bit of a tutorial. So it's positional. So optimally, I would do something like this, where I'd hit all three at the same time. Cool. Pick up the pickaxe. This one just seems to have an AoE. They obviously intend you to play with the controller. I play even most games that would do better with a controller, with mouse and keyboard. For example, I beat Bomb Rush Cyberpunk with mouse and keyboard. So keep that in mind. Oh, we're supposed to be going over here now. Costs a lot. Right, this is a thing. I really need to just use Q and E. Rotating with the right mouse button and dragging is very, very slow. Okay, so we crash landed on this place. So you're just slowly building up a little world, it seems. Okay, just refine everything, I guess. I'm assuming I'm going to need refined materials, and wood seems to regenerate, so. So am I only really able to go in particular directions? Level up, gather speed, damage, or... Go ahead and do gather speed for now. I can sort of feel it. All right, it seems to automatically swap to the correct thing. I can sprint, okay. I was wondering for a second, like, can I sprint? Let's press shift. I vaguely remember that I already confirmed that in the controls menu, but I am not good at remembering things with my goldfish memory. All right, so I guess we're just going to... That was such a delayed achievement, okay. That is interesting. I'm curious, can I change the controls thing? General, manually switch tools, manual actions. So I have to use left click to do shit. I also have to manually do this. That's pretty good, actually. I prefer that one. All right, gold is from monsters being killed. I need that in order to get that one piece of land. There's a lot of forest over here. Can I set up something that does some of this shit automatically? That is my question. I use a sword to loot the chests, it seems. All right, it is slowly losing stuff. There are two bars now. Just takes a while, it seems. I can sell wood. You will buy wood. Alright, I need, I can press 1, 2, 3 to jump straight to specific tools. That is good, at least. So it feels a little bit more like an accomplishment when I'm actually, you know, forced to manually click, mouse click. So. I sort of like the manual controls more, but it feels like it's something that could totally be, like, if you really want to play this very casually, auto can work just fine. The auto is more likely than not because a remnant of this used to be a browser, mobile game, sorry. Oh, hello. What is this then? There's so much forest out here. I have a lot of wood. Alright, so wood is a more renewable way for me to get shit. Get money. At this point, because of that one merchant that I got. It's a very slow, casual game, it seems. Alright, let's kill you. What is this? There's gold here, so this tells me that there must be some way I can... Oh, upgrade 30 of that, 10 of this. Okay. Now, I have a curiosity question. Can I mine something with the inappropriate weapon? Period. It's gang sp- Yes, you can. It's just supremely slow and not worth it. But I was just curious. Okay. One is axe, two is sword, three is pickaxe. I don't like that. Mostly because of my personal preference for, like, the order of my equipment. Hey, chat. I say chat. I'm recording this off stream. Hey, if you're watching the video right now, what is your order for your tools in Minecraft? Like, what is on 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in your bar? Assuming you play on PC. If you play on, you know, console, then not really. I doubt there's really much there that you can do, but... Oh, they're bigger trees. They survive longer. Okay. Screw you, wood guy. So these trees yield more. Because they last longer. So this is just a better forest now, isn't it? Even though he's made of wood, it's still better to fight him with a sword, it seems. So just all mobs is sword. There aren't any that happen to be weaker to pickaxe or axe from what it looks like, at least. Because that would be the perfect opportunity to introduce that mechanic. It did say different tools worked better in different situations. Oh, yeah. There's a way I can... Okay. That is an AoE little thing I can do. What is this saying? 140 crystal, 60 of that, 20 of that. It's only really going to show once I have everything I need, I think. I still have yet to confirm whether or not there is a max cap. There is a cap on wood. I have yet to figure it out. Alright, I do have stone. Is this going to give me another stony area? Oh, this is to upgrade the sword. Okay. Need more of that and more money. Okay, we're gonna require money. I'm actually low on wood. Right. The one thing I would like an analog stick here for is orienting myself such that I hit everything at once to just be more efficient, but that's one of the shortcomings of mouse and keyboard in this circumstance. It's still very playable. How much is it for the next one? I need 60 of this. I don't have any. I have crystal. I need more of that. So I'm just going to do that more. Oh yeah, and I can finish this thing now. Oh, is this like a fast travel kind of thing? Alright, so I have 270, give me 90 of that. Just do it. I don't know if they're actually, like, mildly different units, but one of them didn't have the hat. So I don't know if it's, like, a stronger version or something else. I have 20 of these. I need 60 of those. They're in process, and I need more crystal. Basically, I'm just gonna mine crystal for a while and not spend it much. Or see if I can find another area with more crystal yet to mine. But first... Oh, come on! Get down here! So I can actually hit you, you bitch. Yeah, you don't hit at all above you, it seems. Or at least that's what I experience. Stronger sword. Crystal. Alright. I should just go do this because this is using wood, not crystal. Alright. Another spawn spot for crystal. Alright. So, there's gonna be a lot of dead time. Source, this is for cake. Just skim around until you find something interesting or I talk about shit in the audio track. Because otherwise, it's probably not going to be too interesting to edit. Alright, I should be able to upgrade my pickaxe yet again. No, I am now missing that. Alright, two hit those. Alright, I think the thing it wants is some form of cut crystal, because it had a different shape than just the generic squares of these. Alright, faster. Certainly does something. Those abilities with the faster cooldown can actually speed things up a little bit. Oh, hi. Fuck are you. Alright. I kept saying it, but after I get these next couple areas set up... Ooh, hello. Oh, boss? Ow. Didn't even necessarily want to fight. You're a spellcaster. Oh. It's almost better than mining in any other way, just because of how quick it goes, because of my double thing. Cave Guardian defeated. I can sell crystals to you. For money. I mean, other than the few things that have requested money as part of their resource cost, I haven't seen any other real use for money. New stone thing, gotcha. Cave stone. We down in the mines now. Oh, shit. Yeah. 100 crystal. I need whatever thing refines crystal, honestly. That's what I really need the most. I actually don't know if that's faster. I knew I was overdue for a mob spawning after one of these. Find myself counting the number of hits I have to do each time. Oh,
in case you're wondering, my gaming PC, which actually plays the game, just crashed entirely. It just shut off. No blue screen or anything.
Straight up. Does it autosave though? That is my question. You're now going to find out. I do not believe this game is particularly overpowering anything. Oh, wow. That is another crash. Okay. That's the end of the recording for now. I'll get back to this game later. So this is Darktide, which is a Left 4 Dead-like first-person shooter slash melee game made by the same folks that made Warhammer, The End Times, Vermintide, and Vermintide 2. It is decently graphically demanding if you want to have it on really pretty settings. And while it's gotten better, a good deal, when it first launched, it was definitely not very well optimized from everything I noticed playing it. It is loading, and I am simply going to load into a regular match. And by that, I mean just do a single player attempt, not even really at a level, to make sure that there's a bunch of like movement and particle effects and everything going about that would actually cause stress on the computer as much as it could possibly. I was able to play through a whole entire match without it super overheating. I'm going to start recording again in a short moment once the computer's had a little bit of time to cool down from playing the previous game. And then we're going to start up my little universe. And I'm going to show you something. All right. So, booting up core temp again. Everything's at about 50 now, which is about where it tends to sit when it's idle on this computer. Let us boot up my little universe, which is the little mobile port game that I was recording for a review when my computer shut down twice. You can already see that everything's popping up. I already have some decent max graphics. I'm going to get into the game. It's a very simple graphics game. I have graphics set to low, and there is not much that the game is thinking about. There aren't a lot of mobs that are active. Like, there's that, and that's about it. There's these guys. Cool. That's basically about it. But you can already see that this is not a game that should be demanding a lot of my computer. And yet, I'm going to play it a little bit. And it is very likely going to go into the 90s and peak in... Some of them will peak at 100. Because that's what I did last time I attempted to record a little bit of this. Yep, I'm already getting warning cores. Yeah. A game with this, like, degree of graphics and simple gameplay should not be threatening to overheat my CPU. Darktide, I can sort of understand getting into the 90 degree area range, especially considering I'm not running it, wasn't running it on super low. I did lower the graphics a little bit, but that really didn't seem to matter for the CPU usage, to be honest. This game should not be threatening and having cores maxing out at 99 Celsius. That just should not be happening for something that is a mobile port. So this is very unoptimized and seems to be very CPU heavy. So I'm going to exit to the main menu and exit this game outright. And immediately, everything dips notably and starts to cool down. Top of my computer feels overheated. So, yeah, this really doesn't bode too well. I am not going to continue the rest of my review of My Little Universe because of these concerns, and since it already forced my computer to shut down twice. So, that is the extent of what I'll be able to review. It seems like it's a cute game, it seems like it's fun, but I'm worried for my computer's health, and I need to get a new CPU cooler. Thanks for your time.